شهرٌ عظيم عظيم عظيم. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله ثم الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وبعد. We give thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we send the blessings and salutations upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to extend the blessings down to the companions and to everyone being Allah ta'ala. We would continue with our book of manners, Kitabul Adab, and our topic of focus today is going to be the manners of eating and drinking. Subhanallah, this is an action that takes place every day. This is an action that we do every day. And that is why when some of the disbelievers were making fun of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they were making fun of him that he eats and he walks in the market. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا لِهَذَا الرَّسُولِ يَأْكُلُ الطَّعَامُ وَيَمْشِي فِي الْأَسْوَاقِ. What kind of prophet is this? He's eating food and he's walking in the market. They were trying to make fun of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But below that verse, Allah responded to that message by saying, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا قَبْلَكَ مِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ إِلَّا إِنَّهُمْ لَيَأْكُلُونَ الطَّعَامَ وَيَمْشُونَ فِي الْأَسْوَاقِ. Prophet Muhammad, we have not sent any other prophet before you except that they used to eat. So this is just to say that eating is part of being human. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he never eats, he never drinks. And that shows his perfectness. That shows that Allah is mighty, and that shows that Allah is not relying on anyone. So before we go into details, before we go down to list the points and explain them, it is very important to know that there is nothing that we want to know that is not recorded in Islam. Quran is a book that entails every facet of life, and that is why in Surah An-Nahl Allah says, وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابِ تِبْيَانًا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ. We have sent down to you Al-Kitab. Al-Kitab is another name that is representing the Quran. وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابِ. We have sent down the Quran to you تِبْيَانًا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ. تِبْيَانًا. So that it will be an expository analysis of everything that we need in this world. As an introduction to the topic of today, manners of eating and drinking. The very first thing to note about that is Allah wants us to eat what is halal. Allah wants you and I, as Muslims, to eat what is halal. And that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhar rusul, O the prophets of Allah, kulu min at-tayyibat, kulu min at-tayyibat. Eat from tayyibat. What is tayyibat? Tayyibat means the nice things, the halal, the things that are permissible, the things that are pure. وَعْمَلُوا صَالِحًا. When after eating, then you can be able to perform good deeds. إِنِّي بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ عَلِيمٌ. I am aware of everything that you do. Then the question that comes to mind over here is, how do we know? How do we differentiate between the halal and the haram? That is why scholars of Islam have come up with a principle to make us understand that every food, the basic ruling of every food is halal, except when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it haram in the Quran, or the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has made it haram in the ahadith. So an example of a food that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made haram in the Quran is pork. Allah says, حُرِّمَتْ عَلَيْكُمُ الْمَيْتَةُ. حُرِّمَتْ. It has been made impermissible for you. It has been made haram for you. Al-maytatu, eating dead animals. Wa-damu, and blood. Wa-lahmul khinzir, and pork. That is an example, that is an exception to show that everything we eat, the basic ruling is halal. But then we have to check the Quran, check the ahadith to know which food are haram, which food are haram. Then we go to the points, the manners, the things that we need to beautify ourselves with, the things that we need to follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in while we are eating or when we are drinking. The first one that I would like to share with you is eating and drinking in dishes or with utensils that are made of gold and silver. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in an authentic hadith in Sahih Bukhari and Sahih Muslim, he forbade this. He said, لا تشرب في آنية الذهب والفضة. Don't drink في آنية الذهب from a cup that is made of gold and silver. ولا تأكل في صحافهما. And don't eat from the plate that is made of gold or a plate that is made of silver. Why? Why is the Prophet ﷺ asking us not to do this? He says, فَإِنَّهَا لَهُمْ فِي الدُّنْيَا. These plates that are made of gold and silver are for the disbelievers in this world. فَإِنَّهَا لَهُمْ فِي الدُّنْيَا. These plates that are made of silver are for the disbelievers. وَلَنَا فِي الْآخِرَةِ. And it is going to be for the minun, for the believers, those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Qiyamah. This further explains that on the day of Qiyamah, the disbelievers will be deprived. They will be deprived of using the plates of gold and silver. It is going to be part of the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be giving the mu'minun, because they were able to stop themselves from using these plates while in dunya. In order to further establish this prohibition, it was also recorded in an authentic hadith in Sahih Bukhari. It says, لَا تَشْرَبُوا فِي آنِيَةِ الذَّهْبِ فِي آنِيَةِ الْفِضَّةِ. لَا تَشْرَبُوا فِي آنِيَةِ الْفِضَّةِ. Don't drink from cups of silver. فَإِنَّ الَّذِي يَشْرَبُ فِي آنِيَةِ الْفِضَّةِ. Because the one that drinks from the cup of silver, إِنَّمَا يُجَرْجِرُ فِي بَطْنِهِ نَارًا. The Prophet said, the one who drinks from the cup of silver is taking into himself نَارَ جَهَنَّمَ, the fire of Jahannam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us. So this shows that one of the manners that we need to make sure that we pay attention to is not to eat from plates of gold and plates of silver, or not to drink from cups of gold and cups of silver. The second manner that I would like to share with you today is the manner of placing eating even when the time of salah is ready. In the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Idha wudi al-asha, when the night meal, the dinner, is being served, wa uqimati salah, and salah is being observed, fabda'u bil asha, then you start with the meal. Don't be in haste. Don't be uncomfortable, because sometimes we may feel, oh, salah is being observed, we need to go to prayer. Yes, true, we need to go to prayer. Salah has a very good status in Islam. But this is the command of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إِذَا وُدِعَ الْعَشَاءَ, when the night meal is being served, وَأُقِيمَتِ الصَّلَاةِ, and salah is being observed, فَابْدَأُوا بِالْعَشَاءِ. We need to start with the food so that after the food, we can go and pray bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Why is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam advising us in this way? The main reason that scholars have pinpointed is that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was advising us in this way because he wants our mind to be connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He wants us to have a very good and nice communication with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maybe if we didn't eat before coming to salah, maybe we would be thinking about the food while we are praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even in another hadith, the Prophet said, فَلَا يَعْجَلْ, don't be in haste, don't rush your meal. Why? So that we can be comfortable and so that we can feel happy, we can feel at ease to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another manner, one of the important manner, is that whenever we want to begin our meal, we should start with Bismillah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was advising one young boy. He said, Ya gulam, Bismillah. Whenever you want to begin your meal, say Bismillah. Mention the name of Allah. It was said that this boy wanted to start the meal without saying Bismillah. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam held his hand and told him, Ya Gulam, Samillah. Oh young boy, mention the name of Allah. Mention the name of Allah. For what reason do we have to mention the name of Allah? Scholars of Sunnah have said that the reason why we should mention the name of Allah is because Shaitan will have a share of our meal. Shaitan will have a share of what we are eating. If we don't say Bismillah, then we and Shaitan will be dining together. You see, this is just to show that if we don't really want Shaitan to come closer to us, part of the reasons why we should uphold the Sunnah of saying Bismillah is what we have explained before. Saying Bismillah is a very good thing. It has been placed in a lot of positions in Islam. For example, if you want to go to the washroom, the hadith says what? You should say Bismillah, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-khubuthi wal-khaba'ith. Also, if you want to undress, it says what? Allahumma, say Bismillah, then you undress. So, saying Bismillah should be a habit that we should cultivate in everything that we do in life. Then let's say, for example, we are humans. We forget to say Bismillah at the beginning of the meal. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam provided us with another hadith. He says, if you forget, you say Bismillahi awwalahu wa akhirah. Say Bismillahi awwalahu wa akhirah. In the name of Allah, in the beginning of the food, until the end of the food. When you say this, it has already covered the protection that you're looking for from Shaitan has already been given to you. Then at the end of the meal, we should thank Allah. We should what? Say Alhamdulillah. Thank Allah. Be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that meal. A lot of people are out there. They couldn't get the food. But you have gotten the food. You should what? You should say Alhamdulillah. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we thank Allah, Allah says, La in shakartum, if you thank Allah, La azidannakum, then surely I will make increment, I will increase in my favor upon you. So what is the real hadith? What is the main hadith to say? The Prophet ﷺ in another hadith says that we should say Alhamdulillah alladhi at'amani hadha wa razaqanihi min ghayri hawlin minni wa la quwwa. Alhamdulillah alladhi at'amani hadha. Praise be to Allah, glory be to Allah, thanks be to Allah, alladhi at'amani hadha, the one who has provided me with this meal, wa razaqanihi, and the one who has made it my rizq, min ghayri hawlin minni wa la quwwa, of which this is beyond my capability, this is beyond my ability, meaning it is not my power that I have provided this food. It is with the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is with the mightiness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even when we are showing gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are showing Allah that we are slaves. We are his slaves. We are his abd. We are showing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is our Lord. We are returning back the favor to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is why in an hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, Inna Allah la yarda. Allah is pleased. La yarda anil abdi an yakul al uklata fa yahmaduhu alayha. Allah is pleased that a slave eats a meal. Just one grain of rice. Fa yahmaduhu alayha. And this slave will thank Allah for that grain. Aw yashrab ash-shurbata, or that slave drinks a cup of tea or a cup of water. Fa yahmaduhu alayha. And that slave also thank Allah for that cup of water. This goes a long way to explain that we should say Bismillah, and if we forget to say Bismillah, we can say Bismillah awwalahu wa akhirah, and at the end we should remember to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we should not be ungrateful. The last manner that I would like to discuss with you today is the manner of washing our two hands. Washing our two hands before we start the meal. Right? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِرِينَ. Allah loves those who strive themselves to attain purity, would strive so much, so hard to make sure that they are clean at all times. So it is part of the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that we should clean our hand. Make sure that your hand is clean before you dip your hand in the meal. So today we have mentioned about four manners. Bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, we would continue with our manners tomorrow. Bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.